Contractors. We got talking about this the other day because of the WAG app. Describe the WAG app for the uninformed.
I don't know much about it, but it's been all over Facebook lately. I guess maybe they just launched it or something in the area, or has it been around a while? It's a dog walking app where you can find dog walkers just in your area. And I don't know much about it, but we also were thinking about that new Amazon thing. Is that live in Baltimore where the people, the big thing was where you had to get like a camera and you set the camera up by your door and you can see the person and they have access to your house. They open the door, they put your package inside, and then they lock the door. Much like this WAG app where the person has to go into your house.
Amazon Key. I think that's, is that it?
Get your dog and then walk your dog. But dog walking is nothing new, right? This is something new, but it's just with the, you know, in the days of old, you know, these people would be vetted, or you'd find a person through a friend, or, you know, this would be...
Now you're leaving it up to this app to do it for you, and fingers crossed their algorithm and their screening process is up to speed, and you're not going to get somebody doing something weird with the dog, or in the case of the Amazon Key, which I believe is active in, like, you know, the big three, Chicago, LA, New York, where they're already rolling it out, where you're letting people in your home to do something.
Spiegel, never.
Ever.
Never. No, you're not allowed.
No, I mean, you would, under any circumstances, would this ever happen in your world?
No.
Where you would not be home, and then somebody providing you a service would be going into your home while you're not there.
Absolutely not.
If they find the trap door under the rug, holy hell, hear those people down there? What the hell?
Well, I mean, your maid cleans your house while you're not there, right?
Okay, absolutely not, except in that situation.
But you are there most of the time.
Sometimes, yeah.
And she has an explosive anklet on.
But I do trust her.
Where does this door go?
You want to tell Josh the tale you told us about the contractor that was over to do some work, and you hearing a weird noise downstairs? I didn't want to tell your tale before telling to him. Him being the dog lover, kind of give him the cliff notes of it.
This is totally different.
It was still a contractor and still in your home, but you were there, but in a different part of the house.
Yeah.
Now imagine. The reason I asked you to bring this up is because you were there and this happened.
Right.
Imagine if you're up the street, say, "Hey, I'll be back. Do your business. When I get back, let me know how it went." If you weren't there to turn the corner to see,
super Cliff Notes version. It was before we were selling the house, and I had to get a few things installed, and I had to have some wires run. So the company, the big company, I won't say who they are, but they kind of subletted it out. The truck that pulled up said, like, wires.com, or I don't know what the hell it was. It wasn't, like, the big name on the side of the van. It was a sublet company. And... so we're fishing wires. So I'm down in the basement, like, helping this guy, like, fish some wires. I'm lending him a hand. And then I'm still down there. And then I hear, like, my dog yelp. I hear, like, a yelp. And I go, that was, like, weird. So I go upstairs and, like, the minute the guy walked in, there was a weird vibe to the guy. And I walk upstairs and I'm like, what the hell was that? I'm like, maybe.
Everything okay, dude?
The dog just got, like, scared or whatever. And it was just kind of a weird vibe in the room. So I, like, go back downstairs and then I'm like, I had a really weird feeling, so I crept back upstairs, and I crept slowly around the doorway into the living room where he was. And Giorgio was a loving dog, and he was, you know, always wanted to be by people and around people.
A 4-pound chihuahua.
And I see the guy looking down, and I can't see the dog because the dog is so small and he's on the other side of the couch, but I put two and two together. The dog was down on the ground behind the couch, and the guy is, like, looking down at the dog, like, revving his drill and, like, throwing it, like, in my dog's face, like violently, like, trying to, like, scare my dog, or I don't know what he was doing.
He's antagonizing a chihuahua with a
power drill. And he looks
up
and he sees me, and I see him, and we meet eyes, and he kind of was, I can't remember how it went down, but he kind of, like, just was, like, changed the subject or, like, dismissed it. And I didn't do anything in the moment, but you're damn right. I called that company.
I filed
a complaint.
Oh, good.
And I don't know if I got him fired or whatever happened to him, but I didn't want to have, like I said, the guy had a weird vibe about him.
Like, don't let this guy return when he gets.
Yeah, I mean that you don't know what that guy's capable of.
Right. So in the moment, I'm like, I'm not.
Jesus.
And that was weird. It's a different kind of thing because I was there, but imagine.
I can't even imagine what I would do in that situation.
Oh, he never shows back up for work the next day because he's eating his own fingernails for sustenance as he's handicapped from below the knees, misery style, with a sledgehammer.
back in the day, they called this hobbling.
Yeah, he definitely did something to my... I don't know what he did. When I heard that yelp, I was like, well, that dog just lays on the couch, doesn't bother nobody. If he does, he's walking up to you because he wants to, like, kiss you.
And the reason I brought that up in relation to, you know, sketchy contractors coming in the house when you're not around is I just thought, in a hypothetical scenario, you're not there? What's he... Is he going to kick the dog? Is he going to... put the drill up against the dog and whatever. That man might have not had a well mind. I could only imagine the apocalyptic hell you would unleash upon anybody brandishing a power tool at Shiloh or Pumpernickel. That man is introduced to a seventh level of hell they didn't even imagine existed. You ever wanted to see your own spine? You're about to. 410-338-1098. We're just talking about sketchy contractors, people that have been in your home, do work, do whatever, that you're like, man, shouldn't have done that. That was strange. Let's go to Dave Dundalk. What's up, Dundalk Dave?
Hey, what's up, guys? How are you?
How you doing, brother?
Good, good. So we had I had a hose bib outside, like, freeze up or something, and I had the PVC crack. So I had this contractor come over. I don't know where my wife found him from, and he was, you know, had to cut a hole in his drywall and fix the PVC. And then how he got my wife was, he said, I want to install these flow monitors or something, like, in your sinks to, like, stop the water from flowing. It saves you on your bill and all kind of nonsense. Mm-hmm. He ended up stealing my wife's wedding ring.
Oh.
And, it's like $16,000. And so, like, a couple weeks later, my wife's like, have you seen my wedding ring? And I'm like, no, obviously I don't wear your wedding ring, you know.
Yeah, right.
You know, maybe she misplaced it, you know, it's in a purse, whatever. And then we get a note taped on the front door that this dude stole the wedding ring from some anonymous person. I think it was either one of his, you know, junkie buddies.
Somebody
or maybe he burned.
God, no.
Did you ever get it back?
So I'm a sergeant in the police department. I run a detectives unit. So I start checking through this dude, like, through every pawn shop database and every single thing. Never pawned it. I got the laser inscribed diamond. So I was checking for serial numbers through that, through gemologist and all kind of stuff.
Nothing.
Never found it.
Never.
Son of a bitch.
Damn. Yeah, man.
God, and then give it a call, bud.
And his wife was there, I think.
Exactly.
I don't know. Sounded like it. But, like, I don't know. It's just these new services with this WAG, with the dog walking app where
you're letting strangers,
yeah, letting strangers into your house, right? If it's a dog walker who's recommended by friends and, oh, they walk my dog and they walk Susan's dog down the street. She's great. You're going to love her. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, fine. An app finds this person. You don't know this person from anybody. And then they're coming into your house and they're going and getting your dog and they're walking the dog, or this new Amazon app where they're opening the door and putting packages in your house. You don't know these people.
A lot of underwear sniffing going on.
I mean, it's convenience, but at what cost?
Let's talk to Greg. Let's talk to Greg online, too, in Greenbelt. What's up, Greenbelt, Greg?
Hey, good morning, guys. Good
morning, buddy.
Hey.
I'm just like the other gentleman that just called in. I was local law enforcement before I went federal. I have a former police canine, a drug sniffing dog.
Hell yes.
And we had to do some, and regardless if it's referral or app, I'm always at the house when I have a contractor coming to my house, regardless.
Okay.
So anyway, these contractors show up and my dog immediately started growling and sniffed through the guy.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, gentlemen, do you have anything on you that you shouldn't? I said, I'm not the local law enforcement, but you're not going to do any work in my house.
Yeah, my dog used to be a detective.